A week later, after the attack on Mpondwe Rubiria Secondary School in Nyabugando Village, Kasese District, teachers, students and parents are living in fear of their security. Urban TV made a survey and spoke to students of various schools, especially those neighboring Mpondwe Rubiria Secondary School, and they opened up on their fears.
I had the incident in the neighborhood. Myself, I had a lot of fear and I couldn't withstand this situation. I had to run to our home, and on reaching home, I found that the situation was not all so good.
These people who have attacked us, how are we going to overcome this situation? And I was so very stressed about the thing that happened.
I was scared and I felt pity for the children which were at that school when they were killed.
42 people lost lives, with the 43rd person who succumbed to her injuries while in hospital. Several were left nursing wounds at Wera General Hospital and 6 were abducted during the attack. Teachers are concerned this term's performance might decline for many of the learners. Speras Muhindo, the deputy head teacher, Nyabigando Baptist Vocational School, said since the attack, only 4 learners in the boarding section have returned back to school.
Now, we have received only 4 learners who have slept within our school as boarders. Others are still fearing, but we have hopes they will have to come back, because the members from security, UPDF, have earlier informed them about the security.
A number of head teachers are requesting government to accord them security personnel to create a comfortable and secure environment for learners while at school.
The government to provide schools, both private and government, with armed forces from the government, both during the day and at night, and more especially with schools which have some children who are in boarding.
The vice chairperson, Mpondwe Rubiria Town Council, Yunus Kahwa, appealed to parents and teachers to remain calm as security is on high alert.
Yeah, the situation, how it is going on now, yeah, the fear, silly parents and the learners fearing to come to school to acquire education. So I'm calling upon them that this, as per now, our security is okay. The security is good. They should not have fear again. Let them come to school and learn. Nothing shall happen because the security department is playing its role.
Leaders have called for combined effort from both security organs and the local leaders to sensitize and encourage learners to resume school to prevent increased cases of school dropouts with their associated challenges. Relatedly, Minister Miri Babirye Babalanda appealed to the resident district commissioners and their deputies to work closely with immigration officers and police to assess persons entering the country.
Is that the president has stayed in the area for hours and has capable of doing anything today, such as feeling an involvement. All of the attacks by the area being persistent, we should not take chances. RSCs and deputies must be on high alert. They should work closely with the migration officials and the police to assess the persons entering Uganda.
Babalanda, who was presiding over the belated Women's Day celebrations for Hoima District, explained that during her recent visit in Chiwale District, she found out that people from Rwanda and Congo were entering Uganda freely and in a casual manner.
During my recent tour of Chiwale, I met many people originating from Congo and Rwanda. We should not stop them, but they need to be thoroughly trained and their proper documents examined.
The minister has also cautioned Hoima leaders on political division.
I received complaints about land traffic and illegal actions in this region. I wanted this report to the State House and Corruption Union and the Office of the State Minister for Land, for Work, Protection, Management and Intervention. Some two of these matters to gradually reduce.
Report compiled by Niwagaba Katoto and Samuel Amanyire for the news.